Hey everybody, it's Jang here, and I just got my January 2016 LEGO catalog, and I thought I would share the experience of going through it for the first time with all of you. I'm sure that there are plenty of folks who have received this weeks ago, maybe even over a month ago, but contrary to popular belief, I am last to get many things. They're obviously focusing quite a lot on Nexo Knights right from the very start here, which is cool. I'm glad that they're putting a lot of effort into promoting that thing, given that it's new and it seems like they've put a lot of effort into developing it. I'm anxious to see how that ends up turning out and how well it catches on. So far, so good with the sets and with the show as well. It's kind of replacing Chima, at least for now, not replacing Ninjago. Ninjago continues on through 2016 and beyond. I've reviewed some of these sets, some of them I've not, but I will be reviewing all of them, and I'll also be putting them together and keeping them together for quite some time as they continue to go through the process of adding new seasons. The thing that I like the most about the first couple episodes that they put out of the show is that the voice actors are not annoying. Like with Chima, that was the thing that I liked the least. I mean, the whole premise of it is a little iffy to me, but I think the storylines were pretty good, but I did not like the voice acting, especially of Laval, and being the main character, that one just bugged me. But these characters all seem to have a good amount of self-respect, and I really appreciate that. I think that's really important. Star Wars, well, what do you know? The Force Awakens stuff. As of the time of the recording of this video, some of these sets have not come out yet, or they've come out in some places, but nowhere near me. Once again, very frequently last to get a lot of stuff, just the way it is, but I'm okay with it. It's all good. Plenty of sets to review. Obviously that one came out before. Looking forward to trying out some of these second wave sets. Yes, all first wave stuff. I'm surprised they didn't just put all the second wave stuff together at first, or did they? Did they? Not all of it. Millennium Falcon, yeah, we're very familiar with that one. These are some second wave buildable figures here as of the time of recording this video. I still need to do Phasma and Rey and Finn. Those will be coming pretty soon. Mindstorms. How is Mindstorms doing, folks? I haven't followed the world of Mindstorms for a long time myself. My first time coming out of my Dark Ages, back in 99, 2000 or so, I actually got into Mindstorms quite heavily and started building stuff before I took myself out of it. I haven't heard a lot about it. I mean, they continue to develop it and come up with new versions from time to time, but I don't know how popular it is. Somebody in the comments, let me know what you think about that, about the popularity of Mindstorms. Is the whole LEGO robotics thing still going strong? Because I just personally don't know, because I just haven't looked. These look really cool. New architecture skylines. I feel like it's a great direction to go with these, and this is the first time I've ever seen this. They've recolored the trophy piece to sand green. I love that. Oh, I love that so much. I hope there's an extra spare included in the set, because I want a bunch of those so I can set them up as just little memorabilia and stuff, that little swag that folks can buy on the street. A little model are statues of the Statue of Liberty. They're perfect for that. Venice, Berlin, these are really nice. I really like this line. I hope they'll continue with it. Got that same piece done in white now, and this is another one in gold. We've had that color before, but white, awesome. That's great. And I love the sand blue here too. I always like the sand colored stuff. I wonder if that is a print or a sticker. I haven't looked into it yet, but oh, these are definitely, I'm certain those are prints down here. Interesting. Another one right there. Cool stuff. And I hope that they do bigger stuff in that Skylines series as well. It's a really good concept. This mine loader, it's a relatively obscure bit of subject material there. Unless you live near a mining town, I might not be getting that one. Drag Racer, I will definitely be getting. Nice to see the Azure pieces, but I've liked drag racing at various points of my life, including at a very young age, so I should be able to appreciate that and share some of that appreciation in the reviews. This one, I'm not sure if I'll even get also. There are plenty of folks out there who do Technic stuff, like Sariel does great. Sorry if I pronounced that incorrectly, but does just amazing stuff with Technic, and he also does custom stuff, so I recommend that folks really focus on the expert opinions for Technic stuff. This one looks interesting to me. Even though it's a bigger one, I might actually get that and check that out. I'm interested in it. Minecraft stuff, interesting. They're not showing any of the new stuff. I guess the new stuff won't be coming out January 1. It'll be later on, unless it comes out across the pond. You know, Europe and Asia, they might do January 1 release for the newest Minecraft stuff. This ideas stuff, already reviewed all those. It's all well and good. Ninjago, yep, still around, but this is the last season. This is one of the better sets, I think, that LEGO has made in recent years, period. Whether you like Ninjago or not, it's just, it's good stuff. F40 Mini Cooper, I didn't realize it still sold the big camper van. I haven't reviewed that one yet. I might get to it. It's a low priority for me relative to other stuff, but I might get it before they get rid of it. Modulars, okay, here we go. Palace Cinema, Pet Shop, Detective's Office, Parisian Restaurant, and Brick Bank. There's the newest one. I've got my review up of that, but all of these look good, but of the five, I can say with certainty that I believe the Palace Cinema is the weakest of them because of the interior. I think the exterior looks really nice. I did full reviews on all of these, of course, but the car is very, very weak. The interior is very, very, almost depressingly scarce. What they did with the theater section, the upper level on that. These other relatively new designs, I think, are just fantastic. Fairground Mixer still being sold. I'm surprised they didn't put in the Ferris wheel here as well, at least as a small little inset. Ghostbusters, the big one. Gosh, 4,634 pieces. $350. Oh. At least the price per part is good, but that is expensive. I mean, it's probably not expensive for what you get, but it's just expensive, right? It's a lot of money. Wow. Looking forward to that one as soon as it's released in a few days here now. But that's going to be a long build. Long build. I have to film that one too. Looks good though. Tons of figures. I really like the ghosts, even though they're small. But I do like them. I think those are based on the Screamer molds from the previous season of Ninjago. The big old helicarrier. Nice big size. Looks impressive on display, except for the bridge. But I wasn't the hugest fan of this one as a set for, again, $350. Just not sure. The newer stuff, Avenjet Space Mission. I liked this one quite a bit. Iron Skull Sub-Attack, very small, but really cool figures with that one and nice shaping. Yeah, that's a bunch of stuff that I've done. Looking forward to this one. I have not gotten this one yet. Nice to be able to get Batman and Superman both from Batman vs. Superman in such a small set, just $13. I expect that one to sell really, really well, and I hope that LEGO will continue to do more small sets. This one was good for the figure selection as well, and this was a fantastic set. Oh, it's so much fun. Just a proper playset. All right, let me see if I can find anything else new. Ah, there. I have never seen this before in my life. Wow. I'm sure there are tons of photos out there and it's been covered and everything, but I had not seen it. I was not aware of its existence. That looks really good. I look forward to this one. I look forward to that build, and I look forward to the boat build as well. It also has a helicopter, but these are going to be my favorite. Lakeside Lodge, what is this? A replacement for the log cabin? Look at that. Look at the moose. This is the first time I've seen this one. Again, I'm sure that the pictures have been out there, probably for weeks, if not months, but it's new to me, and I think it looks really cool. It has a different shape to it. They got away from the rectangular and corner thing. Nice. Ah, I like those little 2x2 round tile pieces with a hole in the middle. Such great little lily pads. It's perfect. I love the parts that LEGO's been coming out with, new parts in the past couple of years. They're finally kind of opening up and doing new stuff. Really nice looking sandwich little facade right there. This is another one that I definitely was aware of this one coming, but I hadn't seen any pictures up this close. Flower Shop is small, but it looks good. Looks really nice. Look forward to that one. Done those already. Bionicle. I'm looking forward to this. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time right here, right now. because I want to reserve judgment for my actual reviews of these, but I'm looking forward to them for sure. It seems to me that the designers did listen to feedback from the community, and they've made some more textured pieces, and they're adding more intricacy to the designs. A lot of folks have complained about the newer sets being simpler. They're not simpler. They have way more parts for a given character or a given character type than older sets for the most part, but the armor pieces are just really flat, and I covered that many times in my reviews that I wish that they had a little more detailing on there. It seems like they've done that. It's also nice to see some familiar pieces and some familiar designs coming back, just a little bit of healthy nostalgia in there. I think is a good thing. I think Umarak is going to be out very soon. And then the Prison Island, the new fire or police stuff, covered these. That is one that I had not seen much. I was aware of its existence, but I hadn't really taken it all in. It's interesting. It is interesting. I love these pieces right here. Looking forward to checking out the Prison Island itself. That's the main new set for this sub-theme. Could be interesting. Hopefully it has a lot of play value to it. Looks a little bit on the small side. I wish, I don't know. I'll have to reserve judgment on that till I can actually get it in front of me and spin it around and see just how deep it is and everything. Feels like for a prison, maybe it needs a little more prison space, some more cells or something. A couple of ladder trucks, one articulated, need to check out. That one doesn't look all that great to me on the side, but these are always very cool. I think it's the first time I've seen those that ladder piece connected with the guardrails connected end to end like that. Covered those except for this one I have not done. Definitely looking forward to that. An interesting different design, but stuff with campers and caravans frequently looks really really nice. And all right, creative, just classic stuff, bricks and stuff. And then Friends and Disney stuff. This is a sub-theme that I'm not familiar with here. Whisker Haven. Tales, what does that say? Tales with the Palace Pets. Not familiar with it, but I like the animals. I think the animals look cool, and these always introduce new colors for parts, or just bring in parts and colors that have not been very, very frequently used. So a haven for new pieces for custom builds. Already covered this and this. Some more Friends stuff. Again, animals and pieces. Ooh, is that a normal orange or is that the orangish yellow? I think that's the orangish yellow, the key to orange color for the bike. I, for some reason, love to collect different colors of bikes and motorcycle bodies. I don't know, but that will definitely be added to my permanent collection right there. I love the little bunnies. Those are great. Oh, wow, look at those hats. Those will probably work with the... Oh, yeah, they do. They work with the figures. Duh, right there as well. Cool. And this looks good. This looks like a very good set. The more I look at it, the better it looks. Definitely looking forward to that. Again, with parts, medium blue there. These nice kind of gazebo... I don't know what you call that, but... got a couple of sets this time around that have those. Supermarket, good. Finally, another store where you can buy something other than just sweets and treats and stuff. Maybe some actual normal food. We'll see how these work out. Little ones, I'm not sure if I'll do both of those little ones. Continuing with the outdoor theme that they started the previous year with Friends, I think is a good thing. I think it just sets a good example for kids to want to think of outdoors and outdoor activities with good thoughts. So this type of stuff in general, I support very very much. Even when I don't like the sets in particular, it looks like these will all be pretty good though. But it's just good stuff to reinforce. Livy's Pop Star House looks like it's going to be a pretty good one as well, just from the outside. I'll have to see how it all goes together. Looks like it is able to come apart. That's nice. And TV Studio. All right. Fair enough. Those are probably going to be stickers, but useful pieces up there. They are based on chrome, it looks like, because I see some reflection right there. I think those are chrome-based stickers. And there you go. Brick Bank, once again. I guess they really want you to know about the Brick Bank. Well, there you go. That is the latest January 2016 catalog that probably many, 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 many viewers have seen long ago online, or maybe even received. But like I said, just got mine and just thought I'd go through it and share my thoughts. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.